common said, Angela, should I say today? Us Americans, do I say today? But it's actually today. And my friend Angela, we're going to have an early dinner at a ramen place. And then we're going to an art opening for Jen Mamus of Made by Girl. I've been following her blog for a while now, so I'm excited to go to her art opening. I'm really excited for her. I really can't afford to buy anything, although I did buy a piece of art from her at the last art opening. So you guys will be coming along with me to that, and I think you'll be really pleased with her work. I think it'll be quite a treat. So I will see you guys in the city next. Got out of Jen's exhibit. It went really well, and she explained all the different paintings. So it was kind of nice to hear what she had to say about each piece of artwork. Also some great clothes there. Might have to go back and get some of those clothes. So that's it for tonight. So today it starts for me. It's a Vlogmas. It's December 4th, and I don't do videos every day. I do one big video, and then I post it toward the end of December. I try and do it before Christmas, around Christmas Eve. That's my goal, I don't always make it. It's also my Parisian nephew's birthday, number 4th, Sarge Vlogmas, which is really cool. And I'm meeting Elle of the Elle Diaries for lunch. But before that, I'm heading to a pop-up event with Dara Sanders. It's an all-women-owned pop-up event. So pretty excited for that, they're pretty cool. And then I might do a little shopping in Macy's. I had to pick up something for Christmas for my mom. And so, and then it's a lunch with Elle, so I'm pretty excited. And I have this coat on here that I got at the little thrift store actually across the street from the train station I'm at right now. I think I paid $20 for it. I really can't go wrong with that, and it's really warm, so. Anyway, I'm gonna have my breakfast today. It's Dunkin' Donuts instead of Starbucks. And the next stop will be on the pop-up event.
At the base, flip it over, snap your side pieces, and in less than 2 minutes you can instantly customize your own handbag.
Oh wow, so you can mix and match,
you like can pick and match colors, make it all one color, kind of make it however you like, change it around depending on season, where you're going, your look, and it's great to travel with because you can take them apart just like this in panels, take like 4 or 5 colors with you, and it looks like you have 4 or 5 bags without having to take all the bags with you.
Oh, great. And then
you just add your handles, and then you can adjust the straps longer or shorter if you like. Make it a shoulder strap, or you can carry it here. And some of them, the small size, you can even add a crossbody chain.
Oh,
so you
great.
Can make it a crossbody bag.
Oh, very nice. Very, very cool.
Super fun. They're great for storage as well. You can take them apart and just store them easily.
And you have different sizes?
And then we this made a small size. We also customized a medium and a large size.
Okay. Very cool. And then you have these here that are just...
Yes. So then these are already made. They
already
come as
ready
is,
made, yeah.
And all mini bags and just different leather finishes. So we have the Saffiano leather, we have the pebbled leather, we have some limited edition. And then we collaborated with Tech Tech, who's our street artist, and he hand painted these.
Oh wow, very cool. Yeah, he's noticing that. Those are really fun. And yes. Kind of the art, it's kind of trending now, like, you know, art bags or like, you know, kind of that artistic.
He hand painted those.
Accessories.
And then these we teamed up with Johnny Dedeker, who's also a painter, and he created these based off his art pieces.
Oh, very, very cool. You gotta love the gold.
Gotta love
gold. Pop
the
bling.
Yeah,
exactly.
Handmade in India.
Okay, it's very cool.
Thank you.
I like the statement earrings. They're really trending right now.
Yeah.
Statement earrings, or like they call them door knocker earrings. They're really big ones. And I'm very cute. Very cool. And the hair bands. Oh wow, very cool.
So we're Little Words Project, and we are the founder of the Friendship Bracelet. It's a pay it forward concept, so you wear your word as long as you need it, and then you pass it along to someone else who may need it just as much as you do. And then the cool part is that there's a little tracking number on the tag, and you use this number and you put it in our app or on our website, and then when you pass the bracelet along from person to person, you can see where the bracelet has gone.
Oh, very cool. That's a very cool concept. And what gave you the idea?
So I'm not actually the founder, but our founder, she... made these bracelets in her sorority.
Oh, okay.
So they were called Warm and Fuzzies.
Okay.
And they had nice messages on them, and then she just had the idea of starting the brand, and now we're in Nordstrom.
Oh, wow. Nordstrom. Very cool. Oh, excellent.
A bunch of specialty boutiques. We've worked with brands like Nike.
Oh, wow.
Tarte Cosmetics. So we're definitely on the up.
Oh, excellent. Yeah, they're
but it's
very
like a
pretty.
Great gifting item. If someone's going through a difficult time, it's a nice thing to pass along. And I always recommend getting two so you can keep one and then you can pass one along to someone else again.
Hello.
We design and create these pieces together.
All right, so Adele Designs?
Yes.
Oh, yeah,
Adele
excellent.
Design Studio, made in New York City. Studios in East Harlem. Everything is ethically sourced in the U.S. She can finish for you.
Okay. We use 14 karat gold plating. We plate very heavily. Unlike a lot of companies, we use 10 and 20 mils of gold.
Oh wow.
And we do an individual dye process on each one, so no piece is ever the same. And then we clear coat seal them.
Oh wow. Excellent.
It's quite a process.
It is. That sounds like a very...
our colors are very vibrant.
They are. Yes, I was noticing that.
And our earrings, even the biggest ones, are extremely lightweight. So for
that's
woman
good.
Who likes to wear gold jewelry, it's very convenient.
Excellent.
Lightweight, big gold jewelry.
Thank you.
So we founded the company about 3 years ago, and me and my cousin Ellie, who are both survivors of campus sexual assault. So
oh, okay.
It was born through, like... trauma, like art as a trauma form. So we started beading and creating jewelry. So this is our collection, Camarilla. And then 10% of the proceeds benefit Restore Dignity, which is also our nonprofit. So we
Restore Dignity?
Restore
okay.
Dignity, yeah.
Okay.
So we'll pay for rent, medical, tuition.
Oh, wow.
For survivors of cancer.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a lot.
Yeah.
That's really a lot.
So all of these bracelets, these are all real gemstones and real stones from South America.
And these are also from South America?
These are from all over the world,
okay.
So India, yeah, we get them all over.
Yeah.
So this is our fine collection, so it's all 14 karat gold with real gemstone and diamonds.
Okay, 14 karat gold and gemstones? Oh, that's so pretty. I love the little pendant.
Yeah.
So cute. Wow, you guys are very prolific.
Yeah.
And do you make it all yourself?
We design everything.
You design everything, yeah. Okay.
We're actually trained like a couple blocks from here in the Diamond District by a third generation jeweler. So we did like a little bit of an apprenticeship where we like just hung out in the jewelry district until we found someone who would take us under his wing in the studio. Yeah, so we'll like work with mines in South America to like carve all the tourmaline wings. And then we'll often do the design in CAD and then outsource a lot of the production. But the butterflies have been our best sellers, and they're all about Reaper and like Genesis.
Well, butterflies are trending too.
Yeah.
Trending this last couple of seasons. Butterflies have been really big. They've been on clothes, they've been on accessories.
We even have them in sterling silver too. So they're a little bit more affordable, and there's like all sorts of lab-grown opals that have just as much luminescence and like joy.
Oh wow, excellent. Yeah. Everything is so pretty. So you guys design all this?
Yeah.
And you use CAD?
Yeah. These are all lab-grown gemstones, and they have the same properties as like a
excellent.
Topaz.
But they don't, so it doesn't harm the environment.
Yeah.
Oh, excellent. Wow.
Yeah, you don't have to dig them from the earth.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I love your packaging.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, it's brand new.
Very cool. I'm a graphic designer, so I appreciate good.
Oh, good. Packaging. Oh, that's awesome.
Very cool.
Yeah.
Excellent. Wow, it's really very inspiring to hear that something that comes from something traumatic ends up something, you know, so positive. And you guys are so prolific. I mean, there's so much here. And that you just just went out and like kind of just did it on your own, like met this guy and said, hey, do you want to apprentice me? It wasn't like a straightforward plan, I guess is what I'm saying.
Usually when you're assaulted, your path is destroyed. So you don't have, you can't even see or imagine the future because it's gone, you know? So luckily Kristen and I are like cousins and we're like best friends. We were able to like build a path together, and it was like a creative process. And I think it's just like reflected in like the work we do.
And you both experienced this?
Yeah.
Wow, it's very, really prevalent.
Yeah. And a lot of the times, the girls we work with, like, it's really great that we're paying for rent, medical, and tuition, but we're finding just, like, the validation of saying, like, hey, we're a stranger, but we believe in you, and we're here to help, is, like, it heals them. It's, like, insane. So, like, there's, like, something transformative there.
Oh, that's definitely transformative.
Yeah.
It's just, like, again, it's transformative, like rise from the ashes. I mean, it sounds cliche, but there's an element of truth to that, where something bad happened, but then they're, you know, they're connecting with you, which is something good.
Yeah.
You know.
And this pendant actually just won an award, a social impact award. In Hindi, it says, "Use your power, restore our dignity."
Is it this one?
Yeah, kind of like both, but this one in particular. And the idea is to just remember that anytime you get the chance to stand up for yourself or others, take it. Because it's like those little micro empowering moments that can like change the world.
Flattering to everyone, and
so
thin people too.
I developed a creative technology pattern making that allows many silhouettes to flatter women's physique and just make them feel more comfortable in their appearance, whether it's a form-fitting piece or it's a more, you know, relaxed fitting piece. And just personally, I just think it's really important that when women are shopping for clothes, they don't feel like they can't wear something because of their size, whether they're extra small or 5X.
No, it happens. You'd be surprised.
They should all be able to just feel good with this. Fashion's fun. Fashion should be taken seriously.
Yes, it should be fun. Yeah.
Fun. You're supposed to feel good in what you're wearing, and there shouldn't be any
anxiety. Yeah, it shouldn't create anxiety and, you know, trauma and, you know, depression. You should be able, you said it should be fun. And everyone should have access to it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. Everyone should. And my price
Oh, yes, yes. We moderate price point for...
Because at the same time, I feel that women should have to break their bank.
Yes, that's another thing, yeah.
Made-in-France clothing that will last.
And so nice, too. Like, what made you choose Paris?
Just the quality of construction.
Yeah,
in
yeah.
my experience and in my research, I haven't really been able to find another region.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah.
Whether it's $20 or $2,000, it should be something that is going to really take wear and tear.
Yes.
Yeah. So we have to wear our clothes. Wearing one item just one time for me is
no, I know that's
yeah. buy something
the throwaway.
It's just for, you know, multiple years to come. So, but just in researching and developing everything, I found people that really believed in the collection in Paris and understood that I wasn't using the generic sizing chart or the regional sizing wasn't the norm. And they really understood that and they were constructing everything with me.
Oh, excellent. And who doesn't like to say made in Paris,
yeah,
right?
No, it's really
and have a garment from Paris,
kind of
you know, in France.
Also, I'm from New Jersey.
I can imagine,
I went to
you know. And 1 year. You went to FIT, I was going
to
ask. Is that where you learned everything?
I did a semester in fashion design, but my main education was in fashion merchandising management with a concentration in product development, which really allowed me to learn the inner workings of creating a brand or even just being involved.
Yes, in yeah.
So I just always thought that when the day came that I would have my own company, develop my own company, I would do it here.
Excellent.
But life is funny. Things happen. I flew all the way to France. It happened there.
It's very, very cool. And this is your, is that one of your bestsellers?
Yes, it's one of my bestsellers. It's the
yeah,
Mary
I love that
Jane
top.
Chemise. This is in pink.
It's just beautiful. I love it. I love the big bow.
Thank you. I'm very feminine and very girly. And the collection is very feminine. But it's done in a classic way, so you don't feel like too girly.
Yeah, it's not over the top. Yeah, even though the bow is big and pronounced, it's in a solid color. And
yeah.
It's kind of also kind of classic.
Right.
You know, so it's not...
And what makes it fun is that I have this just minimally, but still, it gives it a pop.
It does. Oh, yeah,
and I have it on the shoulder.
I love how it's tapered here, and like you said, the details.
Yeah.
The details in the design, the details in the construction.
Exactly. Everything,
yeah,
I inspect everything meticulously, and until it's perfect, I don't let it out. So it has to be perfect. If it has to be perfect, it has to be able to fit every body type perfectly.
Well, excellent.
Let's do a lot of testing before anything is done.
Well, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Two for me. I'm meeting my friend Kathleen and we're going to BAM to the holiday pop-up shops. So that'll be pretty fun. It's a really nice day. It's like 35 and super sunny and I like the way it's cold and brisk so you can see your breath, but it's also bright and sunny. But those kind of days, I miss those days when I lived in Seattle. In Seattle was generally in the 50s, 40s and raining. You hardly ever had days where it was in the 30s and sunny. It's pretty rare. So when I'm back here, I was very, very excited. So anyway, these I got, little earmuffs here, I wear earmuffs a lot, otherwise I get head. I got these in Paris, not this trip, but the one before. And these glasses, I showed you the other day, they're Tutti Bonetta, and I got these at a sample sale where I used to work. This, my mom gave me, this fun scarf here. The coat you see me for, I'm doing my Fashion Week, last February, wore it a lot. On the stands rings today, I'm gonna have these gloves on, I love these gloves. I don't even remember where I got these. I got it at a little gift shop, I think, but they're great, I really like them. They're warm, and they're super stylish. So yeah, they're fun to wear. Fuel, as usual, Dunkin' Donuts today, instead of Starbucks. So I'm gonna be heading up onto the platform. The train's gonna be here relatively soon. And I'll see you guys in Brooklyn. The first time I've been back to Brooklyn since my wallet was stolen. I'm hoping not to repeat that today. Everything is zipped up and closed, so I have my wits about me. Like, I don't have a migraine today, so yeah. Anyway, so I'll see you guys in Brooklyn. Which I have to say I've never been to. I've never been to them, so I'm very excited to be here. One day we're gonna go to Roosevelt Island, which you guys might have saw that in my summer vlog. But that's another great thing. People come to New York, take the ferry or the tram across to Roosevelt Island. It's very, very cool, a really fun, picturesque thing to do. So we're just strolling here in the beautiful gardens, which we seem to have to ourselves. Except for me here, talking to my camera. So Rowena and I just got out of the chef's table. They're really good, here she is. She had a lovely microblade, you can't really see them, but she had her brows microbladed, which I was like asking her all about that, thinking about doing it. And we just got a chef's table, you probably saw that, the food was so good. And not
it was
expensive.
Amazing,
it was really good, yeah.
And healthy and good.
And so now we're headed to Cezanne. We've been talking about this forever, but we are now heading over to Cezanne. So come with us here in, I guess that's Soho, NoHo kind of area, which is a nice area to be in the holidays.
Yes,
right in town. Sorry, and I just got out of Wild Fang Disorder. It's a great scene. Company, they've been around for 7 years, that's it, and they've already come pretty far in 7 years. So we'll see more about Wild Fang. Really, really great company. They like the styles, right?
Yeah.
It's kind of like I was saying, like cafe between classic wear and street wear. It's really, really cool. All women owned, so it's really, that was
wearable and affordable.
But yeah, so hope to, you'll see a little bit more of that going forward. Saison. We've been talking about doing this for like years, like getting to the Saison store.
For ages, and we're making it happen.
And finally we're making it happen. And because the one in Paris, because I'm always shooting street style and running to fashion, we can have time. So I need to get to the one in Paris at some point. But we're here at the one in New York. And we're about to step in. You can see it's all, it's with the earlier shots too, it's all decorated up for Christmas. So we're on a great block here in NoHo and Lolita, and we're about to step in right now. I love this. This is so fun. Oh my God. The camera just does not do it justice. This is such a cool top. Oh my God. I think about this maybe for Fashion Week. Something to think about. I'm gonna go outside now and show Romina. If you wanted to see it. And this is just phenomenal. I love it. So here's the next one. I Saison. I love this top. I love this company. This company is so right up my alley. I really, really like the aesthetic of this of Saison. I like that. And this is not bad. This is 68, and that's really not bad. And this here is 120. That's sparkle shirt, which you can see here is lots of sparkles. Oh, I really, really like that top. It's not my size. I'd have to get my size if I was gonna get it, but yeah. So now I'm gonna go show Robina this one as well. So today we're here in our little town, Babylon, which you guys may have seen before if you've seen my other Christmas vlogs. It's very picturesque. And lots of little shops to shop in and places to grab coffee and places to dine. It's pretty nice. So we're spending the day here. Maybe go to a movie later, I'm not sure. But keep you guys posted on what we're going to do, what we're going to buy. There's a cute little coffee shop right here I can show you. So we are now in Jack Jack's and about to warm us up. It's super cold. We're shooting in the cold. It's very challenging, but we did it really quick. I think that was like the quickest shoot that we've had. I shot in like 10 minutes. my hands are still like ice cubes anyway, so now I'm going to enjoy our espresso and our cookie cake, and then we're on to do some more shopping. Shop called Urban Farmhouse. I think the old store is called Pandemonium, but it's not Pandemonium anymore. I think it's called Urban Farmhouse. We just got out of that. That was super fun. You guys thought that was cute. My friend got a gift. So now we're headed to, I don't know, keep walking and to a few more stores. We're kind of done with the shopping, and I got this great little gift here. It's a cute little gift, and now we're headed to have some grub at a place called Barica, which is coming up here momentarily. It's also a wine and cheese place, but I have a migraine, so no. Oh, look at this cute little cheese shop. Oh my god. Should I buy some cheese? Oh. It looks so good. Oh my god, my nose is so red. It's like so cold. Never wore it. It's a full leather dress I got about 4 years ago, so I never wore it, so I'm wearing it today. It's kind of fun. It's a big scarf on. Again, like I said, my sequins, I'll be seeing more later, and I got some sparkle boots on that I got, I don't remember where I got those. Yeah, earmuffs here. It's tag. It's like kind of warm. Without we wear hats, they give me static. Hat hair, they flatten my hair, and I think they make me look kind of manly, so I stick to earmuffs. Not my gloves, so some of these. All these again, I love these. And this will keep my little bag, which I got in Paris for shooting Fashion Week. I'm going to put both cameras in here and a tripod, so anyway, I'm gonna head out now. Shane should be here shortly, and I'll be seeing you guys at Hudson Yards, which you probably saw in my summer blog. My family was here from Paris. So I'll be seeing you guys there. Oh my god, Angela, just saw there the art. I like the sculpture. Someone is hidden there, so it's warmer. It's probably easier to survive. It's pretty bloody cold now, so I'm heading now. And you'll see all the great shops they have. See y'all in there. It is over. So I'll show you guys a little bit of all the pretty lights on all the houses, and go home and watch some Netflix and go to sleep.